How to build a social network like Facebook, and how much does it cost? Maybe you have an idea for a specific audience, like musicians, art lovers, travelers, or traders, and so on. Watch this video till the end, and you will learn how to make a social app like Facebook step by step, understand Facebook's pricing model, and how to avoid making deadly mistakes in your startup. My name is Denis Babic, and I'm the founder and CEO of DB2 Limited, software consultancy and development. Let's start. Let's be honest. You don't need another Facebook. You need to monetize your idea for a specific audience using a Facebook's basic functionality. Because Facebook might not solve the problems your audience has, so you need to develop a solution that will. And the way to do it is to focus on one particular core feature, a unique angle that's a complete game changer. Okay. There are a few elements that make up a social app like Facebook business model, and I want to give you a step-by-step guide to these. You have a client app for people to use a social network, and a web admin zone, which allows you to manage users, content, disputes, etc. Inside the client app, you have functions like user profile, friends, chats, newsfeed, your secret sauce that Facebook doesn't have, and so on. I've added these functions to the table so you can get an idea of the approximate hours your software engineers would need. Web Admin Zone allows you as the business owner to manage your users, content, disputes, and many more. When it comes to pricing quotes, many people totally forget to include quality assurance, bug fixing, project management, maintenance, and risks. Also, you need to include the development costs of your unique idea. That one can be hard to estimate without understanding what you want to build. So in this video, I'll work through the core functionality. Okay, if you have an investor and a contract requiring an in-house development team, the social network development costs are likely in the line with the US or EU figures. But if you don't have these obligations, you can easily reduce your expenses without sacrificing the quality by developing your software in Ukraine. Many startups are getting incredible value by doing this. GitLab, Grammarly, Jubal, and many more are all developed in Ukraine by Ukrainian developers. It just makes sense to have your dating app development team in Ukraine. At the beginning, you should focus on a minimum viable product. Let's imagine we're building a social network for crypto traders. Take just one core and unique feature, for instance, purchasing trade indicators or ability to auto-follow traders and copy trade your favorite influencers. And add the most common social network features like user profiles, chat, search, likes, newsfeed, and so on. Your goal is to have value for money at this stage. Don't overdo it. Okay, so what's needed to build your MVP? There are 10 simple steps to follow in your software development process. When you are in the early stage of your journey, the Lean Canvas is a powerful tool to map out your idea and go to market plans. You're going to have to think about your audience and the kind of problems they have using Facebook. Then consider the functionality you can develop to solve these pain points. What specific features might motivate a potential customers to come to your app instead of Facebook? But as you do it, remember, you can't just think in a silo. Look at what your potential competitors are doing and any alternative solutions that might already exist in the market. I'd also recommend considering what might increase your chances of success. Perhaps you have a large community on Facebook already, which means you won't need to run ads, so your initial lead acquisition cost will be extremely low. And how about your early adopters? What platform are they using now, and how could you communicate and reach them now? Looking forward is also important, especially into international markets. Describe what your Facebook clone will look like in 5 or 10 years from now. Investors love forward thinking and a global mindset, as they are always searching for potential unicorns. Oh, and don't forget to include your analytics, revenue streams, and cost projections. If you are loving what you're hearing so far, click the like button and subscribe, because it would help YouTube algorithms to promote this video. Alright, so if you want your social network to be successful, you have to achieve a product market fit. This means solving problems for your audience in a new and disruptive way. Using a value proposition table is an easy way to get started. Picture this. We've got a private group of crypto traders in a Facebook group, and we want to build a solution for them. What kind of problems do you think they will have? Maybe it's things like a private group can be easily suspended by Facebook. It only allows the upload of images and no interactive graphics. You can check traders' signals live or online, and there is no performance history. There is no reputation or feedback system which may lead to scam or fraud from traders. To overcome these issues, a potential solution for a social network like Facebook could have features like an independent app that's fully controlled by you, the ability to post interactive trading graphics, performance metrics on a trader's forecast history, a feedback and reputation system to beat the bad actors. But you shouldn't stop there. What about any additional features Facebook doesn't provide? You could have paid subscriptions to access trade signals, automated trading that connects to a live exchange, competitions and traders' tournaments to find the best traders, and potentially many cool features that aren't possible today. Once we've built these solutions, what kind of outcomes could we expect? Perhaps there is more quality content posted from members, more and more signals from high-quality traders, new and easier way for traders to monetize their content, which creates a highly engaged and active community that will grow exponentially fast. Guys, I know, I've covered a lot, and this new info is complicated. But if you have any questions, feel free to shoot them in the comments below. I'll personally check in and reply to you, okay? Alright, and up next we have marketing. There is three key elements to your marketing. This is a strategy, channels, and execution. Starting with strategy, let's take out niche social network for crypto traders. Unfortunately, the classic marketing strategy of SEO and PPC ads will not work. If you only drive 20 or 30 users a day to your network, all they will see is on an empty feed and they will bounce. Instead, you should focus your efforts on finding influencers, the big influential traders who can be added into your network, and once they're joined, all of their subscribers will follow. If you've done your value proposition correctly and achieved product market fit, the new users who join your network will stay. They'll also tell all their friends about it, and growth will start snowball. You should treat these big traders as your biggest allies, especially if they've been limited on platforms like Facebook. So what you should be doing is connecting with them, talking about your new business model, and share the benefits they will get, like the independent platform, interactive charts, paid subscriptions, copy trading, tournaments, and everything else. Personally, I'd also tell them you'll be advertising your new social network, which will also help them to grow their audience. So it really becomes a win-win situation. Next, we have two different channels you will use to reach new members. This is critical until you reach a tipping point and the network effect kicks in. So you will have to identify where your audience is spending time online and create a systematic mechanism to drive new people to your startup. In our example, with the crypto traders, they're mostly online on platforms like Discord, Telegram, Twitter, and YouTube. Finally, comes the execution. You will need to run paid ads on networks like Google, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Reddit, and maybe even LinkedIn. It's important to hire professionals and not do it yourself. You can find experts on sites like Upwork and Fiverr, and give a priority to the people who have already worked with your audience. So in our case, that would be professionals with experience advertising to crypto traders. Find someone with relevant case studies from their past work, with real data on their ad spend, customer acquisition, and overall effectiveness. It will take time to find the right person. In my experience, it's usually at least 50 interviews. But it's worth it in the long run to build your team with the right people from day one. If you're developing an app similar to Facebook, don't try to reinvent the wheel. It's faster and more cost-effective to simply copy Facebook's functionality, like the chat or the newsfeed. When you do it like this, your users will be very comfortable using your social network, as they won't have to learn something new, while you can put your focus on unique features that are really important for your audience. With a story mapping tool, you can quickly select the must-have functionality to create your MVP fast, and put your focus on functions that can be easily completed and quickly released. A minimum viable product is what you need. Expensive or complicated features like unique newsfeed algorithm or advertisement admin zones can be flagged for a later version of your product. Based on the value proposition research, you should create a wireframe map to organize your ideas into a basic flow and identify any missing user cases or scenarios. For example, our Facebook app for traders will contain basic features like profiles, chats, newsfeeds, and so on. Missing use cases. For example, what would happen if a trader created a version 1 indicator for a particular blockchain, but afterwards that blockchain network was updated? So version 1 stops working and the trader releases a version 2. How would a user who paid for version 1 quickly and easily get access to version 2? Moving to replicate the Facebook design is pretty easy. If you compare existing platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, LinkedIn, Instagram, and so on, you can see they are all quite the same. It's a simple UI design, and they put their main focus on a newsfeed. Searching for inspiration on Behance or Dribbble, you will see many cool ideas. But don't forget about your brand. You need a name people will remember, a bright icon, and only one accent color. But you don't need to reinvent the wheel with your designs. Do what the world's greatest artists are doing and copy others. The software development approach is different from a classic business model because you need to consistently update your app to satisfy the fast-changing needs of your market. But the wrong and over-sophisticated technology stack may lead you to these problems. It's not possible to quickly change your developers. A painfully slow user interface, hard to maintain and non-scalable cloud infrastructure, expensive and overcomplicated technology stack, issues with payments, cloud infrastructure that goes offline if traffic spikes. In the case of a social network like Facebook, you have to choose the right tech stack at the beginning to be able to develop your minimum viable product fast. Using a proper tech stack like Flutter for iOS and Android helps you to have the same code base for both mobile apps and Python, Django, Node.js, Amazon Web Services for the backend will help you to create your MVP fast. Keep in mind that third-party services would also help you to make things faster. Tools like Twilio for SMS, Stripe for payments, SendGrid for emails, and so on. You should never use hyped or sophisticated technologies such as PHP, Ruby, or Perl for social apps because it would be the wrong way and this will lead you to a failure. The right tech stack, it's like a proper diagnosis after a blood test. Again, I would really appreciate if you could click the like and subscribe. It helps me reach more people in YouTube algorithms. And remember to save this video in your playlist so you can easily find it again later. The key benefit of an agile process is speed. But agile can also decrease your speed up to 30%. So what you need to do? Picture this. You have a small team of 5 developers and everyone knows their own tasks, communication flow and code. Developers can make code updates easily because they have a deep knowledge of the product. There is no bureaucracy at this stage. So simple tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs, short meetings, and basic reports are enough for effective software development and communication. But imagine that your company is growing and you have a team of 15 developers. At this stage, you might face problems such as your developers may leave the team onboarding new people becomes increasingly complex. Productivity failing, issues with developers' communication, delivery and deadline issues, problems with code quality and architecture. In order to solve these issues, you have to assign a tech lead to oversee the team, hire a project manager to oversee the project, implement Scrum, sprints, backlog, retrospective, organize daily stand-ups, use advanced task management tools like Jira. After all this, you shouldn't overlook the importance of analytics. Analytics tools such as Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, Mixpanel allow you to measure the number of visits, user behaviors, analyze user sessions, etc. All these analytics tools will help you to have a real-time health check of your software, and you would be able to make the right decisions regarding your software development updates. So far, we've created three apps similar to Facebook that have done really well. If you're interested in how to build an app like Facebook, click the link below to book a 30-minute call with me, and we can talk about turning your business idea into a winner. See you!